Hi, I'm Joe Mulmiller with DEC's Office of Communications. I'm joined today by Randy Walker. She's a research scientist with the Division of Air Resources. How are you doing, Randy?
Good, Joma. How are you?
I'm doing good. So today you're going to show us how to collect an air sample using an SKC pump.
Yes.
So I know when we're taking a sample that the location matters a whole lot. Why don't you explain to us where we need to be in relation to our point of concern?
Okay. So the most important thing is to be on publicly accessible property. So we're in a public park right now.
Okay.
Either that or on a property that you've got permission to take the sample. The other thing that we want to think about is trying to be in a location that's open and close to our source. So we want to be as near to the source as we can. Within a couple blocks would be great.
Okay. What about the weather? What kind of day do we want before we use this?
Weather is really important. You want to pick a sunny day where it's not raining or snowing.
I mean,
clouds are okay too, okay. But you don't want any precipitation.
And a light breeze helps because that'll push that air towards the equipment.
Yes, yeah, a light breeze is perfect, like today.
Right. What other factors do we need to think about when we're collecting an air sample using this?
Well, you want to think about like personal factors. I don't want to pump gasoline in my car and then go take a sample. I don't want to wear any perfume or essential oils. Any personal care products that have an odor to them also have chemicals. So we don't want that as part of our sample. And I don't want to wear any clothes that have been recently dry cleaned. So
okay.
We wouldn't want that to interfere.
Right. All right. So why don't you show us how to use this?
Okay. So right now, it's resting on a tripod here. It's a nice sturdy tripod. I've extended the legs all the way. Just before I get ready to start sampling, I'm going to read over my brochure
okay. That
details how to take a good air sample with this. So the 15 steps on taking an air sample are listed on this brochure, so I'm going to read that all the way. The other thing that's part of the sampling equipment is my field log, so
okay.
I want to make sure that I have that.
And the field log is to write down things like time and measurements and things of that nature.
Yes, and document other things that are going on around you that you think might interfere with the sample.
The guy mowing the lawn, the truck driving by, that sort of thing.
Yes.
All right,
yes.
Got it.
So the most important thing is that we have this pump right here. It's lightweight and mm-hmm. It's resting inside this basket here. So we just place that there.
Okay.
So we have the sampling tube that came inside this envelope.
Mm-hmm.
So take the tube out. Why don't you hold that?
Sure.
So the tube has these yellow cap on the bottom and a clear cap on the top. You mm-hmm. want to take off the caps. Can you hold those?
Sure.
All right. So here's our tube. We've taken off the caps and it's going to fit right on this inlet. And I'm going to press that down so it's nice and secure. So when the pump is turned on, the air is drawn through this tube and it comes out the pump.
Okay.
Go ahead and open up the cover,
mm-hmm.
Turn on the power button, then press the start button, and you can see it's working because we've got green lights here.
Okay.
After the full hour, it will be stopped on its own. Press the power button off, close up the cover, take the sampling tube off, let's get those sampling caps back,
okay,
and just put them back on the tube to protect it, secure it, and then let's put it back in that plastic bag, close that up nice and tight, and then put everything back in the box.
And send it back to our DEC regional offices or the DEC regional office that you got it from.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Great. That was pretty easy.
All right.